God gave his life on the cross to take the punishment for the sin of the world. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Now you probably know that, but you may not understand the legal implications. You and I broke God's law. We're heading for God's prison, a place called hell, without parole, but Jesus stepped in and paid the fine for us. When he was on the cross, he cried out, "It is finished." In other words, the debt has been paid. If you're in court and somebody pays the fine, the judge can say, "This person's guilty, but his fine's paid by another, so he's out of here." God can let us live forever. He can dismiss our case. He can commute our death sentence because of what Jesus did on the cross. The judge can be just. He can let you go because Jesus paid the fine in full and then rose from the dead and defeated death. And now God freely offers everlasting life as a gift to humanity.
People of this Airbnb left us some blueberry bread.
Blueberry bread.
I brewed some tea.
Tea time.
And some apples to apples. Blind cave fish.
What skull do you think?
Yummy.
Do not eat this, people. Thank you. Look at these locusts. Look, look.
Goliath beetles. That is... Wow.
Look, dung beetles.
Dung?
Yeah,
dung.
Shiny.
Yeah.
That's like a palmetto bug. Those things are like in Miami.
Oh yeah, I forgot to look at this.
That's the end of these industrious beetles. Slow and gradual evolutionary processes could never account for the precision and intricate...
Not a wax figure. Those are real people.
This is where they got all their drinking water. The first 2 years of Abraham Lincoln's life, they lived here. Then they moved to Knob Creek until he was seven. Then they moved to Indiana. Wow, it's still running 200 years later. Creek where Abraham Lincoln and his family lived. This was their major source of water for drinking and for their crops. This is beautiful.
Dangerous too.
And then when the water rushes down these hills, the creek would swell and Abraham Lincoln almost drowned and his friend saved him with a branch.